Hello everyone, welcome to Civil Engineering Skills. Let's see that in our network, how can we change the vehicle composition. First, go to vehicle input, right click and show list. So here you can see on our three links, we have provided some vehicles and vehicle composition is a default. Let's check it out that in a default vehicle composition, what are the different classes of vehicles involved. So for the same, just go to traffic and vehicle composition. So you can see in a default only car and SGV is included. So relative flow for both of them is 0.98 and 0.02. That means 90% of vehicles will be car and 2% of vehicles will be SGV. If you want to change the vehicle composition, you can create a new composition. Just right click, add, and you can provide the name. Let's provide the name as VSIM1. Now select your composition and you can see vehicle types that are involved in VSIM1. So you can add other vehicle types, right click and add, or you can add with the help of plus sign also. So here you can see other vehicle types are also been added. Now let's change the desired speed distribution. So for a car and urban area, we can consider the speed distribution as 60-60, for SGV somewhat lower, for bus 30-30. Now we don't require a tram, so we can remove the tram. Man, we didn't introduce any pedestrian yet, so we are removing the man and woman. Now for the bike, let's consider it to be 30-30, and you can see the relative flow is still 1 for every vehicle type. So let's change it to 0.3. 0.1, 0.1 and 0.5. Okay, now again go back to vehicle input and change your vehicle composition to VSIM1. Now run the simulation and see the effect of the vehicle. It is converted into 3D and you can see all other categories of vehicles are also present in your network. If you will look closely, I'm just slowing down the speed of simulation. Now you can see instead of bike, bicycles are there in our road network. So by default, when you are selecting a bike as your vehicle type, that means VSIM will consider that as a bicycle for your road network. So actually we want a bike in our network, and also according to your study area, other categories of vehicles are present in your area and it is not available in a VSIM software, then you can also input them to the VSIM software. Let's see how we can do that. First, stop the simulation, go to base data, 2D, 3D model. So one table will be open and here you can see total 19 models are available in VSIM software. Let's see the characteristics of first option. If you double click that, one window will going to open. Here you can see the preview of that model. That is a car manufactured by Volkswagen. Similar way, if any 3D model available with you, you can input that particular vehicle in a VSIM software. So here also you can modify length, width and height according to your study area requirement. Then also axle position. So all the parameters that can be modified in the VSIM software. Similar way, for example, I would like to add some bike and scooter in my VSIM software, then just right click, add, and here you can see one window will be prompt and you can add your model to the VSIM software. So this is a preview of my bike, so I am adding that. Okay, if you want to change any characteristics, then you can change, or otherwise click on generate automatically and it will going to generate everything automatically. So click on OK button and you can see your bike has been added to 2D 3D model. Let's provide a name to that as bike 1. Similar way, if you want to add more number of bikes, you can add in a similar manner. So to add any type of model in a VCM software, you require V3D file or SketchUp file. Either of that, if you have, you can add any model with the help of both of the files. So as per Indian condition, you will also find three wheelers on a road. So you can also add some three wheelers. So add here, you can add the auto rickshaw. Okay. Let's provide the name as auto one. Okay. Then another type of auto rickshaw. That is also a good option. Okay. Let's provide a name as auto two. For a third type, let's see the preview. Okay, and another one. Okay, so let's set auto 3 to our model. Okay, so provide a name as auto 3. Okay, now let's add them to vehicle class. For that, just go to base data, distribution, and 2D 3D model. So you can see when we will insert car in our traffic composition, that means 7 types of car will be running in our network. So here you can see the percentage sharing of that car also. For example, Volkswagen Golf, that will be 24%, Audi will be of 16%, Mercedes 16%, likewise. So the same way for HGV also, bus also, if you have a different model, you can utilize in the model 2D, 3D. So for our bike and auto rickshaw, we will add a name 300 for auto. Okay, now select our model auto 1, add another one for auto 2, and third one for auto 3. You can also change the sharing percentage of all the models. Let's consider it to be 0.4, 0.2, and again 0.4. So this total should be 1. Okay. Similar way, you can add the bike. But before that, first change the name of bike as bicycle. Now add another vehicle class as bike, and you can select the model as your bike 1. Add another one as bike 2. Now let's change the sharing percentage as 0.5. and 0.5. Okay, now close this table. Now to use our auto rickshaw and bike in our vehicle composition, first go to base data and vehicle types. First include both of them in a vehicle types. Just right click, add, and you can provide the name as auto, and from vehicle model choose auto, and okay. So here you can see our auto will be added. You can change the capacity from 9999 to 3. Similar way, add our bike. So you can choose a bike. Here write down bike, and in a vehicle model, select bike. And okay. So here you can see our bike and our auto is being added. So again, for a bike, capacity to 2. Now close this table and go to vehicle composition. From our third option, replace the tram with auto and replace man with bike. We don't require the fourth category of bike because it is actually a bicycle. So delete it. So here you can see our composition is ready. So you can change the desired speed also. For the bike, let's consider it to be 60, and for auto rickshaw, 30 is good, for bus and car. Okay, so now change the relative flow of our traffic. Consider car to be 0.3, also autos to be 0.3, for HGV 0.05, here bus 0.05, so you can see 3 plus 1, 4, 4, 3, 7, and 0.34 bike. Now go to vehicle input, and select VSIM1 as our composition. Let's run the simulation and see the effect of our change. So you can see auto rickshaws are there in our network, as well as bikes are also available in our network. But if you will look closely, different types of auto rickshaws are present in our network, but that yellow one is looking too small. So you can increase the size of that, or either you can remove that from your network. Okay, so this is how you can change the vehicle composition. You can add different 3D models to your software, and you can evaluate their behavior in traffic. If you have any doubt regarding the content, you can mention it in a comment, or you can contact me in person.